Coming up on this week's newscast, we've got an interview with the new assistant principal and a special student life feature that looks back on some Halloween hot takes from last weekend. All this and more on this week's episode. Get ready, because BNN starts now. Hi, I'm Maria Quiroga. Although we're still 3 weeks away from the Drama Club's fall production, the theater department is encouraging students and community members to pencil in the date for the play now. Join BNI Drama as they perform this year's fall play, Eurydice by Sarah Rule, a powerfully moving piece and a modern retelling of the classic Greek myth of Orpheus and Eurydice, a hauntingly beautiful story of love and grief and the pain of forgetting. Learn more about the show, the cast and crew, and even pre-order your tickets now by clicking on our website. Tickets are $10 online and $12 at the door. The play runs Friday, November 18th at 7:30 p.m., Saturday, November 19th at 3 p.m., Saturday, November 19th at 7:30, and Sunday, November 20th at 2:30 p.m. The Project Now Club will be collecting socks, hats, and gloves from now until November 21st to donate to the Women's Shelter and Carmelite Home. All items can be dropped off in the Project Now box in your homeroom. The top three homerooms that donate the most items will receive a special donut breakfast. And finally, Bishop Knoll is happy to welcome Ms. Lisa Melendez, a former administrator at EC Central, to assume the role of assistant principal. Lauren Drexler and I have the story.
Bishop Knoll has seen some recent changes. One of the biggest changes is the arrival of our new vice principal, Ms. Melendez.
She has a very diverse history and background as an educator and as an individual.
The big thing about me is that I went to the University of Georgia. So I'm a huge football fan, college and pro fan. I taught business. I was the business teacher for 12 years before I got the gig of being an assistant principal.
Ms. Melendez has already seen significant changes at Bishop Knoll from her previous job and is excited to continue the transition here as vice principal.
It's been a little cultural shock. It's a lot different. I mean, the uniforms, they're in uniforms too, but you guys get to wear these nice little skirts. They don't. It's really different. The kids are a little nicer over here, a lot more friendlier. It's a difference.
In her new role, she is looking to instill values she considers important and also her passions.
Well, I have a deep faith in the Lord, and I believe, you know, prayer is very important, and I'm hoping that you guys see the importance of that. I mean, I know you guys are young, but you should still see the importance of at least, you know, praying every day.
Shock your soul, seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeleton.
It's spooky season, BNI, and this year we are asking students for their Halloween hot takes. Black licorice is your favorite candy? Toy Story is your favorite Halloween movie? Let's see who has the most terrifying take this Halloween.
What is your Halloween hot take?
Pumpkin pie is nasty.
Pumpkin pie is overrated.
My Halloween hot take, it's like people just that dress up as plain stuff like tables or like just some house object or something like that.
Yeah, for me, it's got to be people dressing up as the same thing every year, like constantly something that's cliche.
What is your Halloween hot take?
Candy corn has to be one of the worst candies ever.
Candy corn is overrated.
So every Halloween, I see Menards and Home Depot start to carry these 21-foot tall Halloween skeleton decorations. It's the coolest holiday decoration ever. Every house should have one.
Yeah. My Halloween hot take is that everybody should come to the Silent Lamb Halloween Rager!
You keep your distance, be the system untouched. I jinxed myself. I said one take. Oh, there are my bloopers.